Be Wise as Serpents by Fritz Springmeier. Continues. Chapter 1 Who Built Your Frame of Reference? Continues. Chapter 1.05 Mysteries of the Watchtower Society. You will learn in this chapter, you will be informed that the winged sun disk used by H.P.B. and C.T. Russell was an Illuminati symbol and a symbol for the Church of Illumination. You will learn about three mysteries of the Watchtower Society, pyramids, the Golden Age, and the winged sun disk. You will examine Charles T. Russell and his sun worship. I remember the first time I came in contact with Jehovah's Witness literature. I was in high school, and as the caretaker of our family library I puzzled over the symbolic meaning to the cover. Two tiny snakes with protruding gold tongues encircled a winged globe on the book's reddish-brown cover. The book was part of a series studies in the scriptures. What the symbolic meaning of this strange winged sun disk with snakes was not explained. Obviously, the meaning was for those in the know and not the casual reader. The author of Studies in the Scripture spoke of a golden age to come. He capitalized in bold underlined letters on each volume's title page. The Golden Age of Russell had a fold-out chart in the front of Volume 1 about the Great Pyramid. Was unaware of who Russell was, and unable to realize the implications of all this. I do, however, remember those first impressions as a Christian in high school. This is weird. Where did all these strange beliefs come from? It doesn't take much to pique the curiosity of my research-oriented mind. My teenage mind was always from early on searching in an effort to learn, checking out Plato, John Dewey, Will Durant, Mahatma Gandhi, and many other philosophers and religious leaders. As a youngster, I was always asking why. The curious can have a field day with the Jehovah's Witnesses. For instance, why call one's meeting place a hall? Why not kingdom meeting, or kingdom assembly, or kingdom study, or church, or chapel, or tabernacle, or temple, or something else? Why hall? Why all the secrecy? Why are the writers and leaders of the Watchtower Society clouded in secrecy? Why have no membership records been kept? The answer given, that it was a security measure in case of persecution, didn't satisfy me. Why? Because other groups equally persecuted made other choices, choices that are not secretive. Others said, we trust God and are willing to suffer for Him, so why be secretive? What have we to hide? The choice to be secretive is just that, a choice, a decision. And it was made at the top of the Watchtower Pyramid, by the Watchtower President, and now by the governing body. And this secretive attitude permeates down the pyramid to the rank and file Jehovah's Witnesses. I was interested in possibly joining the Jehovah's Witnesses, a stranger related to this author in a chance conversation, but when I arrived at the Kingdom Hall, the meeting had begun. They had locked the door, there were no windows, and I didn't want anything to do with a secretive religion like that. The answer to where Jehovah's Witnesses receive their strange beliefs, strange doctrines, and attitudes comes primarily from two men. Because primarily only two men, Charles Taz Russell and Joseph F. Rutherford, made all the decisions of the Watchtower Society for the beginning 60 years. Ray Franz, who was an important governing body member, stated that the first two Watchtower Bible and Tract Society presidents acted according to his own prerogatives in exercising his presidential authority, with no hint of a governing body. Since these two Watchtower leaders, two other presidents have served, Knorr and Franz. But while Knorr administrated, Frederick Franz was the real religious leader. Governing body member Klein referred to Fred Franz as their oracle. But today their oracle is 97 years old, blind, and only a figurehead. How does the researcher attempt to understand these problems and men? Some of this author's conclusions after years of research, is that there are certainly many pitfalls to investigating secretive organizations. Material written by secretive organizations for the public's consumption are often loaded with fictitious information. Modern Masonic writers are quite frank that the early Masonic writers when writing about the lodge are not to be trusted. Not every Mason author identifies himself as a Mason. The Masons have lied to show their legitimacy and antiquity. The Jehovah's Witnesses have done similar things, but have also deceived to gloss over doctrinal controversies, embarrassing scandals, anything that doesn't square with the image of being God's selfless, pristine perfect organization. Periodically they rewrite their history to match present truth. The Watchtower Society has been taken to task numerous times for scholastic dishonesty. Anyone familiar with the Mormon murders has a chance to know the elaborate deception the LDS, Mormon, church leaders have gone to preserve their power. As the reader will discover, Masons and Mormons are given latitude to explore religious thought, within the limits given them, but the power and integrity of the leadership is an off-limits subject. Two insiders close to the top of LDS pyramid of power, Frank J. Cannon and John C. Bennett, revealed in their books some of the high-level working of the LDS Church. 5 LDS members were forbidden to quote their sensitive material. Both Masonic and non-Masonic writers often have an incorrect view that all Freemasons have a common purpose, common beliefs, and common methods. The higher Masonic leadership has goals which will be exposed in this book. The lower levels of Masonry are a cover, and for that purpose are permitted to have many ideas. Most Freemasons are limited in their knowledge of Freemasonry. The Freemason next door may regard his own personal experience as universal of all Freemasonry. He may have only experienced the lodge in terms of a philanthropic fraternity, and has not bothered to study what Freemasonry has done historically, or what the higher levels reveal. Like army grunts in the field, they have no knowledge of the high-level planning. The Masons have clouded their activities. The higher degrees are called side degrees, and they claim the higher degree aren't higher, but simply on the side. The truth seeker has to work his way through these ruses. How does one investigate the strange Masonic connections of the Watchtower Society, the Mormons, and other religious groups? It's like being a policeman who comes upon a suspicious car accident. If he rules it an accident, rather than a homicide, he will limit his approach in gathering clues. On the other hand, if he assumes the worst and views it as a homicide, he will collect all the evidence he can. This book is an attempt to gather evidence. Yes, the fact that the policeman gathers facts means he's suspicious. It doesn't mean anyone is guilty. For instance, just because C.T. Russell was a Mason, doesn't mean Jehovah's Witnesses today join Masonic orders. Now this author cannot actually take the reader through all the hoops of research he has jumped through to get to his conclusions. But he can pass some of it along in this book, along with his conclusions. This author has concluded that the following statement of Manly Page Hall, a powerful Mason who was on the Secret World Council of 13,6, is an accurate reflection of the power that the Masonic mystery religions feel they have. Under new names and, to a measure, with new interpretation, the old wisdom which guided the destinies of ancient peoples is being reconsidered and restored. It becomes increasingly more evident that wisdom and understanding alone can bestow the security and happiness which all men still seek as the foundation of a useful life. The shadowy forms of the venerated sages and prophets of the Golden Age rise again, inviting our appreciation. Though long exiled from the sphere of mortal purposes, these noblest of men are being re-established as the great teachers of the human race. The mystery religions of antiquity, which flourished long before the rise of the modern way of life, have been brought into clear focus by progressive leaders in the fields of psychology and comparative religion. 7. Manly Page Hall is correct in that Hinduism is presented today under a new name, New Age Movement. And true, the Hindu forms of prayer, yoga, and transcendental meditation have a new interpretation. They are exercises to practice. And the venerated sages of Hinduism and witchcraft have risen and fallen like the Bhagwan Sri Rajneesh and Krishnamurti, and like New Age leaders Jim Jones and Adolf Hitler. However, progressive leaders have not brought the New Age movement into focus. That is why this book is needed. The author's experiences in New Delhi, India were a real picture of the end result of the New Age beliefs. There are many clues around. For instance, this author's stamp collection contained Indian nationalist postage stamps printed by Nazi Germany, just a glimpse of the connection between the Hitler's promised thousand-year millennium and the New Age New Order. The more clues a researcher finds, the worse the story gets, worse, much worse. No, progressive leaders have not brought the issues into clear focus. For those readers who are interested in stories of power, for those who do not want to be compliant servants of a new world order, this book is written for you. Dedicated to those whose love of truth and freedom led them to pay the ultimate sacrifice, death. Let's start by an examination of those three mysterious items of the founder of the Watchtower Society, Charles Taz Russell. Those were the winged sun disk, pyramids and the golden age to come. It is disconcerting to find that these items are three notable things discussed in Manly Page Half's classic reference book on esoteric Masonic knowledge, The Secret Teachings of All Ages. As we flip through Manly Page Hall's book page after page refer to a coming future golden age. We also stumble upon the winged sun disk, on page XLIX, which is explained as a solar trinity, and represents the various sun gods of the ages. At least 8 pages discuss pyramids in detail, especially the Great Pyramid that Pastor C.T. Russell wrote so much about. On page XLIX appears a Great Pyramid drawing from Piotr C. Smith, C.T. Russell's mentor. It is well established that Smith was the mentor of the Watchtower Society's experts on the meaning of the Great Pyramid. Smith was the source of both Manly Page Hall's esoteric Great Pyramid knowledge and C.T. Russell and the Edgar brothers, well-known Watchtower lecturers on the Great Pyramid, knowledge. Ideas don't come out of a vacuum. When something new appears, it is good for us to remember there is nothing new under the sun. I illustrated that point with a personal anecdote in my previous book The Watchtower and the Masons. This book Be Wise as Serpents is going to go over some of the same material on the Watchtower Society as my previous book, but this time more details and better explanations will be brought to bear on the subject. Perhaps the reader can think of his or her own experience that taught him how we derive our ideas from sources, and not from out of a vacuum. I marvel at how much continuity a modern people have with their ancestors. This point was highlighted one day. I was studying some ancient Egyptian cursive handwriting from the 19th dynasty while waiting for my meal in a restaurant. My sample of cursive called hieratratic was about 3,300 years old. An Arab approached me and started a conversation, because he thought I was reading Arabic. That caused me to reflect. The Egyptians had been conquered by the Assyrians, Persians, Greeks, and Romans, and had gone through using various scripts, yet they choose in relatively modern times to use the Arabic script which resembles hieratratic. The word choose here is used on the premise people are responsible for their own actions. People tend to build, to adapt old ideas. People tend to borrow rather than create new. As I did with this paragraph from my earlier book. When we see something new arrive in history, such as the alphabet, then it is valid to question where new ideas have come from. In the case of an alphabet, one looks for clues as to when it was introduced. New ideas rarely come from a vacuum. If the researcher tracks down where Charles T. Russell's ideas come from, he is led to a source that was a common source of other religions too. The researcher begins to see patterns, and to realize that religions stemming from the source of Russell all have a common goal. The rank and file of these groups are of course unaware of much of this, and are unwittingly contributing to a master plan. Russell and the Winged Sun Disk. In 1910, Russell made his second trip to the Egyptian pyramids. He went inside the Great Pyramid. When he returned, he informed the readers of the Watchtower magazine about the pyramid's hidden message. He also instituted some big changes to the binding of his books. His studies in the scriptures received the Egyptian Trinity Winged Sun Disk on their covers, and the other Watchtower books also received it. He also at the same time made an effort to look international, stamping the binding of the covers either London and Brooklyn or Brooklyn and London. Another religious leader, Helena Petrovna Blavatsky, leader of the Theosophical Society, also used the Winged Sun Disk. She by coincidence also started putting it on her magazine's Theosophy in 1912. She had also made a pilgrimage to the Great Pyramid, and like Russell had to go in and explore the passageways and chambers herself. She spent an entire night alone in the heart of the Great Pyramid in the King's Chamber. 5 interlinked concepts of the serpent. The Theosophical Society had a branch in Pittsburgh when Russell lived there, and also in Brooklyn where Russell re-established. It would be hard to conceive that Russell never came into contact with this group. especially since he writes about them, and mentions contact with theosophists. Interestingly, the man who was famous in the Irish Lodge of Theosophy was George W. Russell, who wrote for the Irish Theosophist. The Golden Dawn was a society and the name of that society's magazine that was started by a Mason in 1887. The Irish, especially George Russell, were attracted to this order and its Temple of Isis. The Temple of Isis used the winged sun disk over its portals. The tie-in with Masonry, the New Age, and the Theosophical Society is a close one. The Scottish Rite started the modern Rosicrucians, who started H.P. Blavatsky off with the Theosophical Society. 8. They financed her and her constant travels. The Grand Master of the Brotherhood of Luxor recommended H.P.B. to Alcott with a letter written in gold ink on green paper. 9. Alcott, himself an active Mason, suggested to H.P.B. that they start the Theosophical Society using their group of Masons, Rosicrucians, Kabbalists, and Spiritualists that were meeting in a New York apartment. 10. The Scottish Rite also has published for over 100 years the New Age magazine, and has promoted the New Age movement from the Masonic lodges. The publications of the Theosophical Society are stocked in the Masonic libraries and read by them. Most of the leaders of the modern Rosicrucians have been Masons. The leaders of the Theosophical Society have generally been women who were in CO Masonry. And the TS has also been called CO Masonry. 11. The Theosophical Society has openly promoted the New Age movement, in contrast with the Scottish Rite's quieter methods. The leaders of the Theosophical Society have been Channelers. 12. Which is interesting because so have the leaders of the Watchtower Society. 13. One of the books put out by a later president of the Theosophical Society is titled On the Watchtower. 14. It is a regular part of the Masonic Knights Templars libraries, and is a selection of Theosophist articles. More on the meaning of watchtowers and the parallels between the WS and the TS later. Where the symbol came from, the investigator will find similar winged globes in the pagan mystery religions of the Middle East, but this representation of the winged sun disk originates in ancient Egypt. The meaning is derived from ancient Egypt, and stands for Osiris, the sun god, Horus, and Isis. Those who study Egyptian magic and practice it today use the symbol for its purported magical properties. Emblematic of the element of air, this consists of a circle or solar-type disc enclosed by a pair of wings. In ritual magic, it is suspended over the altar in an easterly direction and used when invoking the protection and cooperation of the sylphs. So says an expert on such magic in his book Practical Egyptian Magic. 15. According to a book used by the Church of Illumination, Rosicrucian, to instruct on their teachings, the winged globe is preeminently a Rosicrucian symbol, although the Illuminati may lay some claim to it, and it may be admitted that it is of Egyptian origin. The winged globe is the symbol of the perfected soul making its flight back to the source of its creation in Elysian fields beyond 16. It is also said to be the house of many mansions, that is the godlike reasoning that man supposedly has. 17. If one investigates further back into Rosicrucian thought, one finds that the German Illuminati used the winged sun disk. The use of the magic symbol goes back to the Kabbalah. The Kabbalists use it to portray Jehovah. However, their full explanation of who Jehovah is that Jehovah is the sun god. He is to the Kabbalists the same as the Gnostic sun god Demiurgus or the Greek almighty god Zeus, which name at times is used interchangeably with Jehovah. The Jewish mystical thought that pervades Rosicrucian thinking then is seen in an illustration of a secret 16th century Rosicrucian book Die Golden Zeit, The Golden Age, which portrays the winged disc with the magical tetragrammaton in the sun globe's center. From the sources quoted, the reader has learned that the Illuminati and Rosicrucians use the winged sun disc. What about the Masons? Illustration from the secret 16th century Rosicrucian book The Golden Age. Masonic use of the winged sun disk upon achieving the 32 degree, the Mason is given Albert Pike's morals and dogma. It is now from the Pope of Masonry, Albert Pike, that the Mason learns that phallic worship is the true worship of Masonry. However, an examination of phallic worship, which is the worship of the regenerative parts, is the same as sun worship, the sun being the symbol of regeneration. 18. The worship of the sun has often been sexual in its ritual. The Elysian fields that the Sun Trinity, the winged solar disk, represents are sexual rituals. Masonry itself claims to perpetuate the ancient mysteries of Isis and Osiris, Tammuz, and Baal-19, which are sun religions that ultimately are derived from a single common origin. In Albert Churchward's 30-degree Mason, book Signs and Symbols of Primordial Man, The Evolution of Religious Doctrines from the Eschatology of the Ancient Egyptians, he states that the winged sun disk is used by 33-degree Masons. The 33rd degree is the highest public level of the Scottish Rite Masons. There are both honorary and actual operative 33-degree Masons. Notable persons, such as presidents and leading clergymen, are initiated into the 33rd degree. According to Churchward, they alone know its meaning. However, exposure to the symbol is almost unavoidable to those Masons reading theosophic literature. "That's the sun disk, R.A.," exclaimed an active 32-degree Mason when this author flashed Russell's cover of the studies in the scriptures. "It's a Masonic symbol," this author chimed in. "No, it's not a Masonic symbol," came the reply. "How did you know what it was?" Complete silence. He had immediately recognized the symbol but refused to talk about it, or his knowledge about it. According to the Masonic oath, they aren't to talk about Masonic knowledge. Questions and objections. Some will object that if Russell went to Egypt, he may have got the symbol from Egypt, and not from esoteric Masonic connected groups. It is true that it is found displayed over Egyptian temples. For instance, one of the most spectacular exhibits ever was the King Tut artifacts, discovered 7 years after C.T. Russell died. Four oak house-like structures, called shrines, contained the body of this minor boy pharaoh. The inside of these large oak shrines were laid of gold, giving us an idea of the splendor the other pharaohs likewise received. Visitors to the exhibit can view the winged sun disk at the top above each door and on the far side or rear panels. However, in drawing representations of this over their temples, the Egyptians employed a variety of styles. The snakes may look like vipers or cobras, and may even be dropping down rather than looking out from the sun disk. In researching what books were available to Russell, and what live Egyptian drawings Russell could have studied of the Osiris, Isis, and Horus Trinity, it is this author's conclusion that he would have seen a variety of representations, none of which he used. However, he did follow basically the way the esoteric Masonic groups drew it, so consequently his source was most likely an esoteric source. Illustrations from references of C.T. Russell's day showing the winged sun disk are provided to document the variety of choice. Some have speculated that the winged sun disk is an angel's wing like a cherub. This is an uninformed guess. A close look at copies of Russell's books in excellent condition will reveal that there are snakes on each side of the disk. Further, Russell passes up ways to use it as an angel. It is undoubtedly the winged sun disk on his books. What does C.T. Russell and the Watchtower Society have to do with the sun god? Surprisingly, there are a number of clues that show C.T. Russell did believe in a sun deity. Russell spoke about Zoroaster as a true prophet, WTO 6, page 14. Zoroaster was considered to be the sun god by his followers. Cyrus the Great, whose name meant the sun, was considered by his Gnostic followers to be the sun god. Russell thought Cyrus the Great was a prefiguring of Jesus Christ. Russell in fact believed the resurrected Jesus was at the center of the Sunday. Russell never left himself without a scripture to explain whatever he decided to believe. Mal 4, 2 refers to, "But to you who fear my name, the Son of Righteousness shall arise with healing in his wings, and you shall go out and grow fat like stall-fed calves." Russell at various times gave various interpretations to Mal 4, 2. A comprehensive examination shows he said the Son of Righteousness is one, Jesus and his church. Symbology of the mystery religions. After reading thousands of pages on the mystery religions, dozens of Masonic books on their religious symbology, various books on the mythic images of mankind globally, and the Christian scriptures, it was clear that five concepts repeatedly have been interlinked with each other on a worldwide basis, and that each of these five interlinked ideas has also been represented by the concept of a serpent, a snake. Place diagram. Here it is understandable how man in various areas could see the stars, the closest star the sun, and fire, and worship these items. It is also easy to see how two internal fires within man, sexual passion and curiosity, could be integrated into the worship of the sun, stars, and fire. If one were worthy of worship, then all the rest were too. It is easy to understand how a priesthood could persuade people to give them authority in order that these items might be properly worshipped. An examination of the related sun worships from the classical world shows that the priests reserved an esoteric worship for themselves that was hidden behind the worship of fire, sex, snakes, and the sun. The Egyptian priests that taught the people sun worship in Moses' day were monotheistic. This monotheistic god was the light-bearer. To understand the significance of pyramids to Masons, and New Agers in general, we can show how pyramids, especially in particular the Great Pyramid of Giza, relates to these five interlocked concepts. The Great Pyramid is important to Masons according to Masonic sources because, A. An initiate, then and now, after entering the Great Pyramid leaves as a god. Light-bearer/godhood on chart, B. The Great Pyramid is said to be prophetic when its passageways are measured. Wisdom, C. Sun worshippers built the Great Pyramid. Sun worship, D. All pyramids are said to emit special energy. E. Pyramids are an architectural picture of an ascended flame to heaven. Fire, F. The pyramid's upward triangle shape stands for the male generative principle. When the Masons Charles T. Russell and H.P. Blavatsky made their pilgrimages to the Great Pyramid and went into the King's Chamber, it is possible the significance of their visits included the above A-F items. The philosophy behind the mystery religions, Freemasonry, Theosophy, Gnosticism, and the New Age movement continue the idea that man should seek out the fruit of the tree of good and evil, for it shall make him a god. These religious philosophies also declare that true Christianity, cosmic or New Age Christianity, is also this Gnostic quest for enlightenment. Point 20. Many Gnostic religions hate traditional Christianity. They have also over the years criticized biblical Christianity for holding mankind back from finding his quest for godhood. For several upcoming paragraphs we will contrast Christianity with the Gnostic quest for enlightenment. We will refer to the head adversary of the Creator, what the scriptures call, the dragon, that serpent of old, the devil, or Satan. RV 20:1. Some readers will hold the view that Satan and demons don't exist. They are free to speculate that, but there is no way to prove their speculation. On the other hand, it is easy to substantiate an objective belief in demons by examining the countless testimonies, etc. about them. J.W. Montgomery in Principalities and Powers, written after years of research into the existence of demons, concluded, "The problem involved in determining whether demon possession occurs and whether witchcraft works is absurdly simple. The documentation is overwhelming." 21. Whatever our view of demons and their reality, there is the visible behavior of humans who are so brutal that we label their behavior as inhuman because they exhibit a cruelty that surpasses all the animal kingdom and surpasses any purposeful depraved needs. So why are these men so demonically destructive? How do we explain a man like Pol Pot who cruelly killed half the people, many killed were of the better half, in his beautiful country of Cambodia? These were his own people. Rational answers fall short of explaining such irrational behavior for destruction. This destructive force may be labeled demonic, whether we view demons as real or as a psychological phenomena. Be wise as serpents. What were the issues at stake in the Garden of Eden? If we are to be as wise as serpents, what was it that the serpent knew that Eve didn't know? The story of the Garden of Eden sets forth the biblical view of this issue right from the first part of scriptures. The serpent knew that man was man, and that it was a delusion for man to try to become God. The only way since then for man to think he has reached Godhead is if he deludes himself. And the serpent is there to help him try. But why does the serpent want man to seek Godhead through taking in the fruit of good and evil? The biblical view of God was that man should not try to determine good from evil by taking in knowledge, that is, eating of the fruit of the tree of good and evil. For man to determine for himself right from wrong is called situational ethics. Rather than man pretending to be a god by declaring what is wrong by his own wisdom of situational ethics, man was to allow God to decide. the Creator had laid down physical, spiritual, and moral laws. But the gift of choice was given to man. That was God's will. God's will allows for bad choices on man's part, including the option by man to reject his loving Creator and make up his own rules in contradiction to truth. Today, we are seeing that many young people do not want the responsibility of making their own choices about what is right and wrong. They are running to gurus, and laying their freedom of choice at the feet of these New Age godmen. "Tell me what to do," they ask. And then men like Jim Jones, who thought he was God 22, make their choices for these youth, often with disastrous consequences. Why does Satan encourage man to seek divinity? Even today people are as naive as Eve concerning the issue. Satan and the demons really hate the Creator and would like to destroy his creation. But how does seeking one's divinity aid in mankind's destruction? The Theosophical Society tells us that all philosophy is an effort to apprehend reality, but it is an effort of the intellect merely, and as such it is, and must always be a fruitless effort. 23. The inability for man to find Godhead by reason and logic has been repeatedly discovered by all the great minds. Man has always failed. For instance, William James the philosopher tells us in A Pluralistic Universe, page 212, "For my own part I have finally found myself compelled to give up the logic, fairly, squarely, and irrevocably. It has an imperishable use in human life, but that use is not to make us theoretically acquainted with the essential nature of reality. To apprehend reality as a truth seeker by using only logic and reason is a dead-end street. God reveals truth to man according to the scriptures, and man obeys. If man chooses not to obey, and insists on seeking truth on his own, he invariably must discard logic and reason and turns to mysticism, the occult and the mystery religions including Hinduism. In order to achieve his delusion of Godhead, the initiate is encouraged to leave reality by using drugs, self-hypnosis, ecstatic activity such as rigorous physical and sexual activity, psychotic states of the mind and trances. The Theosophical Society states, some of our modern philosophers are beginning to apprehend this fact, notably Henri Bergson, who speaks of a higher faculty which he calls intuition, and which he says must replace intellect if we would contact reality. 24. The Theosophical Society believes the world is but an illusion, Maya, an idea they have learned from Hinduism. The reasoning that these people use is a form of reasoning not under God's authority and is consequently according to scripture not under his protection from demonic control. To step out from underneath God's authority is like stepping out from underneath an umbrella during the rain, the protection offered is lost. Although these people use reason, it is a distorted version. The dying words of atheists who exalted reason, shows that they often discovered their philosophy turned out to be a cruel hoax. Does Satan benefit by watching men pursuing altered states of consciousness and tripping out and leaving reality? Yes. A life centered on deluding oneself is a destructive life. Satan's kingdom, often called the kingdom of the world, is taking advantage of man's ignorant groping for godhood. Satan is out to destroy God's creation made in his own image. Get in touch with reality and stay there. Quit trying to cop out of reality. Christians are to test the spirits to see if they are of God. That means elements of logic, science, and reason must be tested to see if they are under God's authority. If they are, then embrace them. Christianity and the scriptures are not against science, logic, and reason. No, those items are powerful tools for Christianity. But when those items are used in a distorted way, that must be avoided. Science and intellect are not to be used to create gods, nor is their purpose to invent systems of morality. Evolution is an example of a powerful warped way of thinking. Because it was developed intentionally as a tool to destroy belief in God, it has not been protected from demonic powers. All kinds of demonic influences have directed the evolutionists, and the list of frauds perpetrated by evolutionists is long. It is also used to teach us morality, such as, only the fit, the best, survive. This means one is superior if he survives by any means. To use reason, science, and reality to become gods is in itself a distortion of reality, a contradiction, for man is but man. In order to delude himself into thinking he is a god, mankind is turning to drugs and other escapes from reality. The Christian NT book of Ephesians chapter 4 deals with sins of the flesh in the context of the old man, verse 22, and the new man, verse 24. In this context, suddenly Paul warns us, neither give place to the devil. Verse 27. By committing fleshly sins, the demons are given a place, lit ground, for their activity in the believer's life. But the Christian idea of God establishing right and wrong for us, is ridiculed as simplistic by all the various Gnostic groups. Christianity, so-called, lulls its devotees into a false sense of security, or salvation, whereas the whole history of humanity, and of religion itself, shows us that, the path by which to deity we climb is arduous, rough, ineffable, sublime. 25. The poem is right. The path to divinity is an arduous path, because it is a path man is not to accomplish on his own. It is a cruel hoax which Lucifer as an angel of light assists. The Masonic lodges which continue the ancient mystery religion, one religion with various names, teaches the initiate that he needs light. Masonic authority McKee in his encyclopedia states, light. Light is an important word in the Masonic system. It conveys a far more recondite meaning than it is believed to possess by the generality of readers. It is in fact the first of all the symbols presented to the neophyte, and continues to be presented to him in various modifications throughout all his future progress in his Masonic career. As a candidate for various degrees, the Mason will declare his need for light. For instance, the entered apprentice, or first degree, is asked by the worshipful master, "In your present condition, what do you most desire?" NCT. Russell, Joseph Smith, Jr., Billy Graham, and Robert Schuller all answered, "Light." 26. Light is the first demand of a candidate at his initiation, and the material light is succeeded by an intellectual illumination. Historical. Landmarks, Volume 1, page 135. This search for light continues up through the degrees. When the candidate receives his lecture for the 32nd degree, he is told, "You are here to learn, if you can learn, and to remember what you have been taught. In the Scottish Rite you will be taught that our ancient ancestors who knew all the mysteries left enough traces so that we today with diligent labor and teaching may renew them and bring them to light for your enlightenment." We now come to the great symbol of Pythagoras. Our symbols have descended to us from the Aryans, and many were invented by Pythagoras, who studied in Egypt and Babylon. In order to preserve the great truths learned from the profane, there were invented some of our symbols that represent the profoundest of truths descended to us from our white ancestors. The ancient masters invented some of these symbols to express the result of deity. They did not attempt to name him, but rather tried to express their reverence by describing him as Ahura Mazda, spirit of light. 27. Ahura Mazda was the god of the Mazdean religion, which worshipped five types of fire. The five fires were the internal fire of the earth, the kundalini also known as a sex force or serpent power, the fire of lightning, the fire of vegetation, and the fire of Ahura Mazda. The ritual quoted above of the 32-degree lecture introduces us to two concepts worthy of note at this point. First, that symbols are used to conceal truth from the profane, and second, that masonry involves the worship of the various five elements of the serpent. In EZ 8, 16, sun worshippers are described facing the east. Generally, sun worshippers have faced east, as the Masonic rituals connected to sun worship do. Because of a number of items, it appears that Lucifer may be playing a larger role within the Masonic lodges than one is led to believe. The symbology of the lodge includes frequent use of the sun, the serpent, and the eagle representing the sun. In order to bait mankind into continuing to self-destruct, Lucifer and his demons have been appearing and providing enlightenment for those who are on the New Age road. It should be obvious that a real angel of light, by Bible standards, is not going to appear to help men become gods. The Bible is clear from the beginning. Yahweh, the God of the Bible, doesn't want situational ethics and man-made gods. Notes 1. The seventh volume was billed as Russell's, but was written by George H. Fisher and C.J. Woodworm. 2. Franz, Ray. Crisis of Conscience. Atlanta, GA, Commentary Press, 1983, page 60. 3. Morey, Robert. The Origin and Teachings of Freemasonry. Morey quotes a number of respectable Masons, for instance McKee, criticizing the Masonic historians of Preston, Huggen, E.T. Al, for instance the Mason A.S. McBride, criticizing 19th century Masonic historians, also Melvin Johnson, critiquing Gould, Huggen, and others, also Delmar Dara, criticizing Masonic historians. It seems that the phrase "first liar doesn't stand a chance" may apply in some ways to Masonic historians. Morey himself isn't honest with the facts. The smokescreens of false information have helped cloud the Masonic Lodge, but it is possible to get to the bottom of it all. Honest men who have left Masonry, like Charles Finney, have been reliable witnesses about the Masonic Lodge. 4. Mormonism, Shadow, or Reality by the Tanners in Salt Lake City does an excellent job documenting Mormon deception. The casual reader may want to read the compelling story about the Mormon document dealer Mark Hoffman and his dealings with Mormon officials and the murders he committed. The book reveals the mindset of the top Mormon leadership. The book is The Mormon Murders by Stephen Nife and Gregory White Smith, New American Library, a division of Penguin Books, New York, 1988. 5. In 1842, John C. Bennett produced History of the Saints. Frank Cannon's material was originally a series in Everybody's and became the book Under the Prophet in Utah. 6. Confidential Sources. As far as seeing this in print, references to a group of 13 men who control the world's religious groups can be picked up here and there in various books, for instance in Stan Deo's The Cosmic Conspiracy. Hints about such a group come through in Manly Page Hall's books, and for a good reason, he sat on the council. 7. Hall, Manly Page, The Secret Teachings of All Ages. An encyclopedic outline of Masonic, Hermetic, Kabbalistic and Rosicrucian symbolical philosophy. Los Angeles, CA, The Philosophical Research Society, 1971, Preface. 8. This was originally revealed by H.P. Blavatsky in her own books. The Theosophical Societies have put out more information on the origins of the Theosophical Society. H.P.B. also refers to other adepts and Rosicrucians who she met in her travels throughout the Middle East, Egypt, India, and Tibet. 9. Ancient Wisdom and Secret Sects. Alexandria, VA, Time Life Books, page 124. 10 Ibid p. 125. 11. According to papers put out by the Deputy of the Supreme Council of Universal CO Masonry for Great Britain and its dependencies by the Grand Secretary of the said jurisdiction, the smaller group that broke away and is headquartered now in Pasadena, CA, claims to be against the idea of CO Masonry. This position is attractive to those Masons who have a difficult time accepting CO Masonry. For instance, Iverson L. Harris, Theosophical leader, while under oath in court in Florida, said, "Neither is our society in any way responsible for the CO Masonic order, which Mrs. Besant organized and publicized widely as a Masonic order for women. A number of our very prominent members for years past have been Masons, and our late Secretary General, Dr. Joseph H. Fussell, was a high Mason, and vigorously opposed this so-called CO Masonic order." Theosophy Under Fire, deposition taken for a court case in F.L. Point Loma, CA, PUB by Iverson L. Harris, page 9. 12. Blavatsky claimed she wrote Isis Unveiled under spirit control. Besant and Bailey, later TS presidents, also claimed the same thing for their books. 13. The Watchtower Society has on numerous occasions referred to themselves as God's channel of light. For instance, The Finished Mystery, 1917, page 144, Watchtower 1/1890, page 1, Watchtower December 1, 1981, page 27, Theocratic Aid to Kingdom Publishers, 1945, pages 249-250. Some specific quotes are that the Watchtower Society is the sole visible channel through whom alone spiritual instruction was to come. Watchtower, see 1956, page 590. Russell says angels helped bring messages to him. Watchtower, October 1, 14. Rutherford declared spirit beings brought him light. Vindication 3, 1932, page 250. Franz also at various times said that angels were bringing light to the Watchtower leaders, see PG 40 of the Douglas Walsh trial. Well, we believe that the angels of God are used in directing the Jehovah's Witnesses. 14. Sri Ram, N. On the Watchtower. Adyar, India. The Theosophical Society. 15. Hope, Murray. Practical Egyptian Magic. New York, St. Martin's Press, 1984, page 107. 16. Clymer, R. Swinburne. The Rosicrucians, Their Teachings. Quakertown, PA, Philosophical Publishing Co., 1923, page 112. 17. Ibid, page 113. 18. Pike, Albert. Morals and Dogma. 19. Numerous Masonic and non-Masonic authors tie phallic and sun worship together. Phallus, a representation of the virile member, male sexual organ, which was venerated as a religious symbol universally, by the ancients. It was one of the modifications of sun worship, and was a symbol of the fecundating, impregnating, power of that luminary. The Masonic point within a circle is undoubtedly of phallic origin. McKee, Albert G. Symbolism of Freemasonry, pg. 352. 20. Kingsland, William. The Gnosis and Christianity. Wheaton, 2, The Theosophical Pub. House, 1975, page 13, etal 21. Montgomery, J.W. Principalities and Powers, The World of the Occult. Minneapolis, Min. Bethany Fellowship, 1973, page 146. 22. Film Gods of the New Age exposes how Jim Jones thought he was a divine reincarnation of Jesus Christ. 23. Kingsland, OPCIT, page 1824. Ibid 25. Ibid, page 2326. Duncan, Malcolm C. Revised Duncan's Ritual of Freemasonry. Danbury, Conn, Barron's Publishing Co., 1922, page 31. 27. McKinney, Tom and Jim Shaw. The Deadly Deception, page 156.